Hello and welcome everyone. In continuation to my series of lecture on CRISPR-Cas9, I would like to let you know a little about the PAM sequence. CRISPR-Cas9 system, as you all know, has caught everyone's attention and it is spilling in over in all the news channels. But PAM sequence also has a very important role to play in this CRISPR-Cas9 technology. So in order to understand its role in CRISPR-Cas9 technology, we need to know what is a PAM sequence. With this thought in mind, I prepared this lecture for all of you. So let us proceed. So our first question is, what is PAM? Now the PAM is basically a component of the invading virus or a plasmid. A protospacer adjacent motif is the expanded form of this acronym. It is a 2-6 base pair DNA sequence immediately following the DNA sequence known as protospacer in the viral genome or the plasmid. So basically, PAM is a component of the invading virus. So it is present in the viral genome and it is immediately following the protospacer sequence present in the viral genome. So now our next question is, what is the role of PAM? So considering this to be a schematic diagram of a bacterial cell, let us see what happens when a virus attacks this bacterial cell successfully. So a virus that attacks a bacteria is known as phage. Now, if the viral attack is successful, the phage genome will get inside the bacterial cell. Now, the phage genome consists of two regions, that is the protospacer region and the PAM region. The protospacer region will be incorporated into the CRISPR locus of the bacterial genome. So you can see that the bacterial genome also consists of various regions. Let us see the regions one by one. The first region is the Cas gene region, which gives rise to the Cas protein. It is followed by the leader sequence. Then it is followed by the repeat sequence. The repeat sequence is palindromic, and then comes the spacer sequence. So the protospacer of the virus or the phage genome gets incorporated into this CRISPR locus and it is known as the spacer sequence. Now the spacer sequence is different each time depending upon the virus that has attacked it. So on the first viral attack, the protospacer is incorporated into the CRISPR locus of bacterial genome and now it is known as spacer. On subsequent attack, that is if the same virus attacks again, the CRISPR, that is the crRNA, which has complementary base pairs, will recognize the protospacer and the Cas9 endonuclease on activation will cleave this viral genome and make it inactive. So the Cas9 will bind and cleave to the target DNA only if it is followed by the PAM sequence. So the Cas9 will be able to inactivate the phage genome only when the protospacer is followed by the PAM sequence. So both protospacer and PAM sequence are nucleotide bases. Protospacer is recognized by the Cas9 endonuclease and inactivated only if it is followed by PAM sequence. So PAM sequence acts like a barcode which codes the protospacer. So I hope now you know what is the role of PAM, that it helps the Cas endonuclease enzyme to cleave. And this PAM is located in the viral genome. It is not present in the bacterial genome. So comes the next question. Since Cas9 is an endonuclease, how is the bacterial genome protected from its own Cas9 activity? So the answer to this question is, that PAM is an essential targeting component which distinguishes bacterial self from non-self DNA. Thereby, it prevents the CRISPR locus from being targeted and destroyed by the CRISPR-associated nuclease or the Cas nuclease enzyme. Now, these are different Cas9 species. These are all bacteria, and they have different Cas9 genes, and they recognize different PAM sequences. So if these sequences are present in a virus, these Cas9 species will be able to deactivate it. If these sequences are not present, then these Cas9 species will not be able to deactivate the virus. Now, if the target DNA regions to be engineered do not have a PAM, then the editing simply will not occur. So this is the application of the PAM, that whenever genome editing has to be done, the target DNA region in whichever species, whether it is human or a rat or any other plant, it has to be tagged with PAM. If it is not tagged with PAM, then editing will not be possible. So the concept of homing RNAs is the next thing. What is the homing RNAs? The DNA sequence that encode guide RNAs are not cleaved by the Cas nuclease themselves because they do not contain PAM sequence. So the researchers have reverse engineered this concept and developed homing RNAs, which target their own DNA sequence for cleavage simply by adding a PAM sequence in the guide RNAs. So their previous studies has shown that homing RNA editing results in far more diversely accumulated mutations relative to conventional CRISPR guide. So homing RNA is basically placing of PAM in the host's genome so that it can be edited. Now, in summary, I would like to go through briefly that the CRISPR loci present in the bacterial genome contain spacers. The viral DNA inserted into the CRISPR locus is known as spacer. It is a type 2 adaptive immune system which is created from invading viral or plasmid DNA. Upon subsequent invasion, a CRISPR-associated nuclease such as Cas9 attaches to the tracer RNA-cRNA complex, which guides Cas9 to the invading protospacer sequence. Cas9 does not cleave the protospacer sequence unless there is an adjacent PAM sequence. So the spacer in the bacterial CRISPR loci does not contain PAM sequence, and thus it will remain protected from the endonuclease activity of Cas9. The protospacer in the invading virus or plasmid contains PAM sequence, and therefore it will be cleaved by the Cas9 sequence. So I hope you liked what I said. By now you have understood what is PAM sequence, what is protospacer, what is spacer, and what are its application. So please subscribe to my channel to hear more simplified lectures on various aspects of biochemistry. Click on the bell icon. Keep watching. Thank you.